repeating groups. We'll talk about repeating group formation in Flexi Layout Studio. We'll talk about the element itself, differences from the group element, how to search for instances, some specifics about instance location. We'll take a look at the repeating group hypothesis and mapping the repeating group blocks. So a repeating group is very powerful and necessary when you've got data that, as pictured here, is separated and repeated. So here we've got table data separated by pickup dates. There's many, many use cases, explanation of benefit forms, high school or college transcripts. Wherever you want to look for data that repeats and it's not in a table format, and also when tables themselves repeat on a single page. Repeating groups are different than regular groups because they restrict, for instance, how many repetitions can be found on a document, or even how many repetitions can be found on a given page on a document. For instance, if you just wanted to find the first three iterations of a repeating group on each page, you can specify that in page mode. Or if you wanted to see the first 12 iterations of a repeating group within an entire document, you can specify that in the document mode. So this is specified on a tab in the repeating group in Flexi Layout Studio. You can search for instances from top to bottom or left to right in different orientations. And looking at the demos, you'll see it's important to use the nearest function to make sure that we're not getting results based on quality, but rather on position. Using the nearest function will prevent data not being found because it's located above instances with better quality. And that's viewable in one of the demo videos. You can describe tables and footers within a repeating group. That's an important capability, especially when tables repeat in a document on a single page. And this is a pretty important slide to take a look at. If you want to make sure that you're looking in a downward motion, you actually point on the Relations tab to the repeating group element name, and it'll be grayed out because it'll be pointing to the current instance. But you need to change that to last found, and it's no longer grayed out. And then you want to look below the bottom of that. And by doing that, you'll ensure that your repeating group is always looking in a downward motion. And once again, using the nearest function makes sure that we're not skipping over items with lower quality to find items of higher quality, because then we won't be able to find those instances of lower quality at all. There's a very useful hypothesis manifestation for repeating groups. So you can double click on the topmost level, and you can see each instance of your repeating group. And you can double click on one of these instances and see what's contained in that repeating group instance. For instance, here a white gap and then a table. And as we know, if we double click further on this table, we'll see the header information, footer information, and body information. So you can then traverse back upwards by using the backspace key. So when you specify blocks, you can specify has repeating instances unless you use a repeating group block from the onset. But if you just create a text block and it's pointing to a repeating group element, you must mark has repeating instances, then map the instance. Notice that you can just select the last found instance or a specific instance number. And you can also specify instance sort order. So usually we're finding data from top to bottom, but I recommend that you set this to in order of finding in case you do something that alters the order in which you actually go find data. So the repeating group block all automatically knows that there are numerous iterations, and the repeating group block will present the data in a more, I think, visually appealing way to the verifier. So again, you can refer to the demo videos to see the difference between these two methods of mapping blocks. Again, specifying a text element and saying it has repeating instances, or creating a repeating block, and within that block you have all the elements that are found within that repeating group. So we talked about the repeating group element. It's used to search for repeating groups of data. We may or may not know how many iterations of that data is in advance. We really don't need to know. And we can look for instances on an entire document, or we can limit the number of instances that we find on each page, say the first three instances on each page, if that fits your needs. And you can specify the sort order, for instance, top to bottom or left to right.